Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to customize the appearance of the React Breadcrumb component using the template options. Looking at this example, you will see the breadcrumb items customized with icons. In addition to that, breadcrumb component items are customized by the chips component using item template options. Let's see how to customize the breadcrumb items in an existing React application. I open the application where I have added the breadcrumb component with 4 items. I have also imported the breadcrumb component from the Syncfusion EJ2 React Navigations package. Follow the link in the card or the description below to learn the basics of adding the React breadcrumb component to an app. Now, I run this example using the command npm start. Look at the output page, the breadcrumb component is displayed with defined items. Next, I will show you how to add icons to these items using the icon CSS property. I define the icon CSS property with the appropriate classes. Then, within this index.css file, define a font face with a specific SRC path and name its font family to access the required font icons at the application level. And, I assign the appropriate content values to access the needed font icons. See the output page, the folder, and file icons are appended to the items. Notice here, by default the icons are positioned to the left of the breadcrumb item, but you can also position them to the right by using the eIconWrite class. To do that, I define the beforeItemRender event with the appropriate event handler. Then, append the icon class to the item by defining the method appendIcon class and passing this class eIcon right through the add method. Here, this breadcrumb before item render event args interface is imported automatically from the Syncfusion EJ2 React Navigations package. As you can see, now the icons are positioned to the right. Next, I will show you how to customize breadcrumb items using the React chip component. First, I need to install the button package using the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2react-buttons-save. As I have already installed the Syncfusion React Buttons package in my application, I am skipping this step here. Next, I need to import the chip list component from the Syncfusion EJ2 React Buttons package. And I also import chips directive and chip directive from the same package to add the list of items to the chip component. Here, I am going to add the chip component inside the breadcrumb component by defining the item template event with the appropriate event handler. Then, I define the method addChipComponent of return type JSX element, which returns the chip component. Next, I add the text property and set the breadcrumb component item's text value using the data parameter. So here, you can see the breadcrumb component items rendered inside the chip component. Next, I will show how to disable the breadcrumb items. To do that, I will add the disable breadcrumb item event handler to the before item render event. Then, I will define this method, which receives arguments of a type breadcrumb before item render event args. Here, I am going to disable all the breadcrumb items except the program files, so I will add the condition: if the item text is not from a program file, then set the item.disabled property as true. To continue further, remove the item template event from React breadcrumb code. See the output page, the breadcrumb component items are disabled, except for the program files item. In this video, we have seen how to customize the Syncfusion React breadcrumb component using template options. We saw how to add icons and change the icon position. If you would like to see a working example, you can download one from the GitHub link shared in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire React suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.